I'm Emily Richett, and you're watching Amplify. In this episode, I'm taking you inside ClickFunnels' annual conference, Funnel Hacking Live, where we'll meet entrepreneurs who are on top of their game so we can reverse engineer their tactics, model their mindset, and hack their success. Hi guys, Emily Richett here at Funnel Hacking Live, ClickFunnels' annual event, and I am here with Dana, the goat farmer, Derricks, who just took the stage. That was incredible.
Thank you.
So much inspiration. I want to know how a goat farmer from Wisconsin is now speaking at Funnel Hacking Live and sharing all this value. You talked about the Dream 100 as a strategy that really grew your business, because I'm assuming you didn't make all this money with your goats.
Correct.
Well, goats can be pretty profitable, right?
That's my next two comic club award, I guess. I'm just trying to be, yeah, from the goats.
Well, you know, goat yoga is a thing, so
yes,
that's next
I've
on your
tagged
radar.
Tagged in it quite a bit, yeah.
All right, well, let's get serious and give the entrepreneurs watching some tactics they can use in their business. Tell us how you got started and what you struggled with most, and then how the Dream 100 worked for you.
Totally. So I got started as an entrepreneur young. So I grew up on a farm, and I noticed early on that I didn't really enjoy like the labor stuff. So I was like, I could make 40 bucks pitching hay bales for 6 hours, or I could go inside and go on the internet and like figure that out. And so I was like, okay. So I did that for a long time. That kind of spiraled into a bunch of stuff and then made a career out of it. And for the last decade, like, it's just been up and down until like the last 2-3 years has just been like explosive. And the reason for that is like, I always had good offers and I always had like good stuff, but I just wasn't able to get the right or even the correct amount of volume or the correct like eyeballs on it. So I was always struggling with like traffic. So I tried like paid ads and all this stuff and it never worked. And then I'm like, okay, let me try something else. And I tried and I like learned about this Dream 100 thing from Russell and Chet. And then I'm like, holy crap, like that sounds like it's for me. And I tried it and then like it's blown up ever since.
Well, for people who have no idea what the Dream 100 even is, explain that concept of leveraging this Dream 100 strategy on our businesses.
Totally. So basically what people think right now to get traffic is they need to go get Facebook ads or like paid ads, right? That's like the, especially people starting, that's like the worst thing you can do, because you have to pay for it, and then if it doesn't work, like, you're out more money and just like taking a step backwards, right? So what I have figured out is I can go to somebody in my network, or I can create someone and bring them into my network, so then I can go to them later on, build like a relationship with them, and get them to promote my stuff. So what that enables me to do is I get free traffic from it, because we split part of the profits on the back end. So I don't have to be crippled by ad spend and ROI on ad spend, and then I'm also get all the trickle effects of somebody like endorsing me and like my celebrity, like all that stuff. So it's just worked so much better to run that instead of like paid ads for me.
So how do we get started with the Dream 100 list?
So define your avatar. So figure out who am I ultimately targeting, and then once you have that really well defined, then just go and find out where they hang out. Like, what Facebook groups are they in? What people are they following? Like, find the influencers that already have that community built, because the beauty of this too is like, honestly, I'm not very good with technology. Like, I don't even have an Instagram. Like, my person that I have has like been yelling at me for that.
We're changing that today.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, yeah, she already yelled at me about that.
It's gonna happen, because there are goats and there's business. Like, two of my favorite things, so we're gonna make that
happen. Who needs Instagram, though? So, yeah, so, like, I'm just, like, I'm too dumb to figure out all those channels, so I'm like, why don't I just have somebody else already do that for me, right? So I'll Dream 100 people that already took all the time to figure that stuff out, they can run the ads to my stuff, or they can hit up their community. I don't want to spend all that time and figure that out, all that stuff out, just leverage their existing community.
And so you just took a whiteboard, and you wrote out your Dream 100, and some of them I imagine, because I was thinking about that, and like, 100 names? I couldn't come up with 100 people. And part of it is some really realistic, low-hanging fruit, like your friends and people you know will do it, but then you also dream pretty big in your Dream 100.
Absolutely. So I tell like quick story like on that. So you just heard my football scholarship story, which was cool and all that. The part that I didn't have time to tell is like I ended up going to a small school, and I regret it because I listened to that doubt in my head, like, you know, Alabama, LSU, Texas, like they'd never ever recruit me, right? So I didn't even try. I didn't even go after them, and I regret that to this day still. So what I tell people, I get asked this all the time, like, who, like, should I go after the A-list? I say, you go after A-list, yes, but also B-list and C-list, because it takes time. Like, the higher, like, the more important or larger influential people are going to be more long-term, but you want to get quick wins along the way, and that's kind of the proving ground for when you go to the bigger ones later on. So I'd say give a good mix of all three.
Sure, and don't be afraid to dream a little big. That's why it's the Dream 100, right?
Exactly.
And tell me a little bit about now, you're creating content, you do things differently. A lot of people, it's a stretch to sell a book for $20. You've sold a book for $2,000.
Yeah, so that basically was, I'm like burnt out from providing a service. So I'm like, I need to bundle this into like a package that I can scale. And then I'm like, I'll write a book, it'll be great. And then I started researching what it would be like to write a book. And I realized, oh, like 1% of authors make money from their books. That doesn't sound great. So I'm like, okay. And then I started diagnosing like why, how can that be? And 30 seconds later, I'm like, oh, it's because everybody sells them for 20 bucks. It's the only thing in the world that is not priced according to value, right? Like it's just 20 bucks. Okay, well, what's a good one versus a bad one? I don't know, you get a chapter and you throw it if it's no good, right? So like, I'm like, okay, I'm not doing that. So then I charged $100 for my first book I launched. I'm just like, dude, that's still a really good deal because I'm charging 10 grand for the service that I'm now like, instead of catching the fish, I'm teaching you how. Like,
exactly.
That's a steal. So then I just like, it was like me versus me. I'm just like, how much can I charge for this? And then I got up to 2,500 bucks and I'm like, okay, I'm starting to feel guilty. Like, so I left it there, but like, I don't think there's a ceiling, but. And the beauty of that though is like, when people pay $2,000 for a book, the problem with books, by the way, sorry for the rant, is like people don't read them. I have a huge library of books that I haven't read, I want to read. But if you pay $2,000 for a book, you're camping at your mailbox. And the time it gets, you're like, cancel all the plans, it's here, read through it, you inhale it one sitting.
You've got your color-coded highlighters,
yep.
You are just diving in.
You're like, I'm not even gonna leave this thing at the gym because somebody might steal that thing that's $2,000 in there. Like, it's worth more than my phone and everything else combined in there. And then you read it, and then more importantly, you implement. Because if you don't, you're out $2,000. So it's like the best thing ever. I don't know why everyone doesn't do it.
Yeah, it's brilliant and you're looking sharp, but at the end of the day, we're still at our roots, right?
Oh yeah, never too proud.
Still a goat farmer.
Yes. Oh, feels
so much
better. A goat
farmer now hitting the stage at Funnel Hacking Live. If you want to learn or you resonate with, hey, maybe we got other goat farmers out there.
There's
at least
one.
But even if you're not, you resonate with Dana's story, where can we find you and learn more?
You can go to danaderricks.com. I have a weird spelled name, but just Google it. You can also, you can grab either a copy of either of my books, highticketbooksecrets.com or dream100book.com. Forward by Russell, it's one of the coolest books. Page 77 will change your life, I promise you. Yeah.
Awesome.
Otherwise, you can find me on the farm.
Goats.